إذا كنت تريد أن تكون على مذهب السلف تعلم مذهب السلف.
We are tried and tested. We are not people that could be tried and tested by whims that are in line with the obedience of Allah. Where's the test? I secretly crave everything Allah loves. That's all I want to do. Where's my test? So is it realistic to expect we're going to reach a state where what? My desires are in line with everything Allah wants? No, then there's no test for me. This dunya is a test from day one until your last day. You're tested and tried. That means you will want things that Allah has forbidden. And you have to struggle. However, imagine a person, everything he really craves, just the idea of it, imagine it, because it's not real. Imagine someone, everything he secretly wishes for, it's all obedience. Now sure, the more you train yourself to be obedient, the more you work on yourself, the more you fight your desires, the easier it will be to worship Allah, and the more beloved to your heart the worship of Allah will be. So maybe if a person is listening to music and living a filthy life, then listening to the Quran for him is so hard. He can barely sit 5 minutes, except he has to get up and do something else. His heart is so connected to music and to falsehood. Then that same person repents from his lifestyle and he begins to read the Quran much, and the Quran softens his heart. And then what happens? He can get lost in the Quran. He can sit down after Fajr and open the Mus'haf, and then someone taps him on the shoulder and says, "Brother, we need to close the masjid. The sun rose a half hour ago." Because why? He got lost reading the book of Allah Ta'ala. He didn't even sense a minute or two going by. That's how much a person can love the speech of Allah and love reading the Quran. It takes training and it takes work to reach a state like that. But even when you reach that level, say you're a pious wali of Allah, highly beloved to Allah, a person of much obedience and much training and much purification, will you have desires that never call you to evil? Will you reach that state? No, you'll never reach that state because you're still going to be tested. As soon as you do step up with that level of piety, who's that sworn enemy that sees you and targets you? The shaytan doesn't leave you alone because you're pious. He leaves the people of fisq and disobedience and negligence. He leaves them alone to do what they're doing. He focuses on the people of piety and obedience because they're the ones that are dangerous to him. Your whisperer, the one who whispers to your chest and withdraws away all of the time and inspires you with disobedience, he focuses on you more now. Because why? You're coming to the masjid. You're befriending the worshippers of Allah. You're leaving alone friendships and actions that Allah is not pleased with. The shaitan has to focus on you more because you are more threatening now. Because you are closer to Allah Ta'ala and you are more of a problem for him. So he gets his army from the jinn and the mankind and he focuses on you heavily. So when you encounter that, thank Allah for that favor. Don't look at it as something bad. Don't say, every time I try to push myself in the religion, look what happens. Fitna and problems and all of that. That's what happens when you push yourself religiously. It's expected. If you know your deen, if you know the nature of this life, that's supposed to happen. Be sincere to Allah and push through it. Be sincere to Allah and look for the reward in dealing with those trials and those calamities and those hardships and the difficulties that you face. Because that's what it means. The shaitan is going to focus on you. Then yes, people are mobilized against you. Statements come at you. Slander, vilification, all kinds of things. Because you're trying to get close to Allah Ta'ala. But go off into disobedience? MashaAllah, everybody left me alone. Nobody's bothering me anymore. Why? Because the shaitan left you alone. He has no need to bother you now. He's got you where he wants you. He's got other people to focus on.